Greetings and welcome, friends. We have been solving equations with variables on both sides of the equal sign. It has been amazing. It's been tremendous. I'm really pumped. We're actually going to spend another day on it today. Lucky for these guys. Might not be the perpetual case for all the classes I ever teach, but hey, these guys are lucky. These are the fortunate ones right here. We're taking a look at page 23, and we're going to take a gander at these four problems. Talking about solving, friends. So here we go, question three. If I want to solve for x, the issue is I have x in two places. So the first thing I'm going to want to do is bring the x's together. And yesterday, my pro tip was this. It doesn't have to be, it's not the only strategy. Maybe today we'll even try some alternate approaches to the same problem and just see like, oh wow, they still end up at the same place. But my pro tip was to move the little guy to the big guy, and negative 2 is less than positive 3. So I'm gonna, to move this negative 2x, the way we did that was with addition or subtraction. In this case, addition would undo subtracting 2x. So I add 2x to both sides, and I write my work in the column of its like term on its respected side. So 15 and is equal, and meh. Equals, let's see, let me line up my equal signs better. The 2x's cancel out over here proper, so that's why they're gone. And 3x plus 2x is 5x. And now I can solve normally. The variable is by itself, so I'm going to get everything away from the variable side. Whereas before, you didn't necessarily want to start moving things until you knew which side to move them to, right? Like once we've committed to a side that x is going to be on, now I know, oh, let's move everything away from there. So it'll save us some work, potentially. So divide both sides by 5 because x is being multiplied by 5. Division is the inverse operation. And let's flip this around all at one step. 15 divided by 5 is 3. 3. Thank you, Austin, if you don't mind taking a break from that. Let's see. Question nueve. Here we go. Even with these problems, the first thing we're going to want to do, like in 9 and 12, is simplify first. So here I actually see a simplify step that I could do. I'm going to combine like terms on the left-hand side. I can't combine the 3x over here yet, Austin, if you don't mind, because it's on the other side of the equal sign, right? So I've got, let's simplify this, 7, positive 3x minus 12x. The signs are different. 12 minus 3 is 9. X's, right? And the more influential one was 12, so it'll be negative 9x equals 3x plus 1. Now, as far as moving the little guy to the big guy, the little guy is the negative 9. Negative 9 is smaller or less than positive 3. No, 9 seems pretty big, but it's in the negative direction. So add 9x to both sides. Oh, I love it. I love it. Yeah, hopefully you guys are correcting your mistakes if you have them, or maybe if we end up with the same solution, maybe you'll be like, oh, I had an alternate solution, and this one might have been easier, right? Let's see. So I've got 7 equals 12x plus 1. Now that I've got all the x's to one side, I'm like, oh, okay, I'm glad I didn't start by moving this 7. I want to move everything towards that 7, right? So I want to get everything away from the x. So what do I deal with first, the 12 or the 1 here? How do I know? Do I deal with multiplication or addition first? Yeah, I'm going to subtract 1, right? SADMEP, we undo what's occurring to x in the reverse order. So I'm going to subtract 1. I just want to point out, if I was like, oh, let's divide everybody by 12, look at how ugly this problem would have become. You still can mathematically get to the answer, but you are going to have to trudge through a swamp of fractions to make it there. It'll be the swamp of sorrows for some. So let's see. Easier is to SADMEP it. Let's just undo it in the reverse order. 7 minus 1 is 6. Yep. Equals 12x. Oh, looks like this might have a fraction answer after all. Now I divide both sides by 12. And I don't mind the fractions showing up at the end. At least we didn't have to work with them, right? So x equals 6/12. I can reduce that 6 goes into 6 once and into 12 twice. So the answer is x equals 1 half. Now, if we want to do a check for these problems, which I'm not going to do right now, I would take the 1 half and plug it in everywhere I saw an x, right? So I would replace x with the 1 half, and then I would just PEMDAS order of operations my way through, simplifying, and then seeing whether or not my left-hand side is equal to my right-hand side. And so I think we've gotten to the point where you guys would probably agree. I would not have been able to just look at question 9 and been like, I think 1 half is the value that makes that true. That would have been a lot of guessing and checking for me that I would rather not do. This is a more efficient and accurate way, rather elegant way, to get us there. Okay, here we go. Question 12, friends. Step 1, simplify. In this case, is distributing. This distribution is, by the way, it's correctly pronounced. I sometimes intentionally mispronounce things. Just because probably, I don't know why, actually. So let's see, negative 9 times t is negative 9t. Negative 9 times negative 2. Remember, this is multiplying, not adding or subtracting. Negative times a negative is positive. And 9 times 2 is 18. Equals, my equal signs didn't line up. That's okay. 4 times t is 4t. And 4 times negative 15 is negative 60. 4 times 10 would have been 40. 4 times 5 is 20. Actually, let me write that scratch work on the side. That's just, right? If I'm doing 4 times 15, this is actually using the distributive property. That, I thought in my head, was the same as 4 times 10 plus 5. And 4 times 10 is 40. Plus 4 times 5 is 20. That's how I got 60. Right? You can actually use the distributive property when you're multiplying numbers and kind of break them down into numbers that are easier for you to work with. Not a bad trick. Pretty good. Pretty good. Let's see. Let's combine my like terms. Oh, well, they're on opposite sides of the equal sign. So I can't just combine them. I've got to move the little guy to the big guy. And this guy, in this case, the little guy is the negative 9. Hey, he was the little guy last time, too. Also, notice how when I'm using the variable t, I put my little tail on the t there, so that way it doesn't look like a plus sign. That's the main reason. Let's see, so add 90, not 90, but 9t to both sides. Equals, 18 equals 13t minus 60. So now that I've got the variable on one side, now my goal is move everything away from that side. So in this case, let's move the 60 first. We'll do that. The inverse of subtracting 60 is to add 60. Man, these numbers are getting big, guys. I'm getting a little nervous myself. 78 equals 13t. I do not know this next arithmetic step. I know the algebra, though. Divide both sides by 13. Right? And let's see, let's flip it using the reflexive property. So 78 divided by 13, guys. Oh, man. 26. Guys, I'm stumped. 78 divided by 13. I'm going to break out long division, which, by the way, even as a math teacher, I didn't know how to do long division a while back. Until I had to like teach pre-algebra, and I was like, wow, I've got to relearn this. Here we go. Let's see. 13 goes into 78. Does anyone know how many times? What's a guess on that? Well, let's see. 20 would go into 80 4 times. This is less. I'm guessing at least 5. What's 5 times 13? 5 times 3 is 15 plus 50, 65. Could that fit another 13 in there? Oh, looks like. I think 6. Maybe it goes in evenly. 6 times 10 is 60, plus 6 times 3 is 80. Oh, we got it! And yeah, in this case, I didn't have to do long division because it went evenly. But hey, that's okay, right? That's okay. Oh, hey. Yo, t equals 6. All right. And most of the time when I write a quiz or test, I try to do friendly, quote unquote, numbers that you could do most of the work in your head. This is starting to get just beyond my reach for like quick math that I happen to have memorized. And that's fine, right? That's fine. We all have different kind of skill sets when it comes to multiplication, division tables. Let's see. Let's look at question 25. So here it says, oh, it's wrong. Oh, man. Now, one of the things I think, first of all, I would recommend for this individual is that they show their work. We don't know what they did from one step to the next. So it looks like now we would have been trying to get the C's together, right? And we would have moved the little guy to the big guy. So I would have tried adding 3C to both sides. And I think we've spotted their mistake. Do you guys see it? Yeah, it looks like they subtracted from both sides. That's what they did. And let's see. Assuming that was correct, let's see if the rest of this problem is right. So let's see. If this was 2c minus 6, then they would have added 6 to both sides. Did they do that step right? Yep, 4 plus 6 is 10. The 6s cancel out, 2c. Then what would we have done? Divide by 2, and the 2s would cancel out. C equals 10 divided by 2 is 5. But yeah, their only mistake was either they didn't use the inverse operation, or they added wrong, or, guys, I thought of another thing that they might have done. This is probably what they did. They probably did this. You guys think that? I think that's more likely what they did. Where they tried to combine like terms, and why is that wrong, Austin? Why didn't... Not quite. Those are like terms because they have the same variable and exponent, but I can't combine them because they're on different sides of the equal sign. So that's probably more likely their mistake rather than not having done the opposite of subtraction part. I'm guessing that's what it is. So they probably got excited about combining like terms and then didn't realize they were on opposite sides of the equal sign. So anyways, thanks for watching, internet friends. Have a great day. Bye-bye.